Hello, hello, this is Jack Walker. We are here at Truro College for the Winterfest of Cornwall Comic Con 2018. I didn't think Comic Con Cornwall would return until just 4 months. I thought we'd wait a whole year, but Truro Comic Con is back for Christmas. Yes, Truro Comic Con seems to be a biannual event here, one in the summertime and one a couple of weeks before Christmas, and I'm so glad. And it's pretty much as that last time I was here. I think everything's changed here. I mean, who would want to be outdoors in the very cold weather? So chilly outside, couldn't wait to get indoors, but it should be a brilliant chill day out. Ooh, there's the Doctor, I can't wait to congratulate him on probably the best Doctor Who series in a while, highest rated on average as well. So, wow.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Natalie, once again, who is becoming the Darcy Bustle of Cornish cosplayers. You know Darcy Bustle?
I do know.
Yeah, is that a good compliment? You are becoming the Darcy Bustle of Cornish cosplayers.
No.
Done so much for the past few years. The Nightmare Before Christmas turns 25. Nightmare Before Christmas is 25 years old. Same age as me, because I was born in 1993. What's also turning 25? Other films that were released 25 years ago. Schindler's List, Jurassic Park, Cool Runnings, so many. Also, The Fugitive, Groundhog Day, Mrs. Doubtfire. 1993 was a good year in film. We meet again, Doctor. Congratulations on the highest rated average viewing figure series Doctor Who since it returned.
Was it?
Yeah, definitely. Just viewing figures going through the roof. Start off good, yeah, but I think last week's episode was really good. The one in Norwegian woods where they go through the mirror world, that was strange. Yeah. It was so funny when the Doctor, you know, went into this, you know, white world and see the frog on a chair and it was the voice of Grace. I'm like, what is this?
Pretty lengthy.
Oh, yeah. Also, like the episode with the witches as well.
Yeah.
That was a weird one.
That was quite like that one.
Yeah.
Tread.
Oh.
Dinosaur in your face.
Might wee on me in a minute. Twerk. Do a twerk. Yeah.
Sorry about that. I was meant to bring it back to the Jurassic period, but I got a bit stuck.
Yeah. Time splitting.
Yeah.
It's
a bit tricky sometimes.
Oh, defo.
I'm trying to stay in the same place, but it doesn't really work.
I think my favourite episode of the new Doctor Who series is the one with Rosa Parks.
Yeah.
It was really good.
Yeah.
I think in the next series, They should try to do more historical episodes. They should go to the 1966 World Cup final, Berlin 1989, fall of the Berlin Wall. Oh yeah, that would be really cool. Or Y2K, yeah. December 31st, 1999. 9/11, just kidding. Ooh. So this is the first Comic-Con event I've attended, and of course perhaps the first Comic-Con or any like geeky event convention here in Cornwall since, of course, the passing of Stan Lee, creator of Marvel Comics. What's also happened since the last Comic-Con here in Truro, who's also died, Aretha Franklin, 41st President George H.W. Bush, Chaz and Dave, Dennis Norden. Oh, we're losing too many legends. What's going on? Well, what's also happened since the last time we were here, England are still a fantastic football team. Roxanne Pallett's career ended, and in the past few days, looks like it's the same for Kevin Hart. Oops, but, it's weird to think 2018 is over in 22 days. Today is December 9th, so yeah, 22 days until 2019 arrives. 2018 has been a good year for me, especially for Cornish cosplayers, as we had a lot to go to. Well, hello there, welcome to Planet Earth. How is it going? Awesome, yeah. And next week, the Strictly final. I think Ashley Roberts should win, but I think Stacey Dooley will, because she has a popular vote behind her. Yeah, in case you haven't, here on Planet Earth, we do love a bit of trash TV. Here in UK, we love Strictly. It's like famous people do ballroom dancing every week. One goes every week and, yeah, keeps us all sane from this horrible world. It's oh so quiet. Shh. It's oh so still. Shh. I'm not sure if I should be here, but obviously, it's like the main hall is where everything seems to be at, but,
Hi, Jack. How's it going?
How's it going, mate?
Very good. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you again.
That's it.
It's awesome. I remember you from the last time, of course.
That's it. Having a good day.
Oh, yes, I am. Just dreading to think who's out of Strictly tonight. Ashley cannot be in the dance-off again. Hopefully not. And who's going to win? I'm a celebrity.
Jack Barrowman's going to win.
John Barrowman. Yeah. I like him.
I like him.
I think Harry Redknapp's going to win. I wouldn't mind if either three won. Yeah. I'm gutted Fleur East went last night. I wanted her to win. She was so funny and down to earth.
That's it. Definitely.
Five Nights at Freddy's. Am I correct? Oh. Usually want to see you jump out through the cameras, don't you? God, I've seen reaction videos on YouTube. They're all playing Five Nights at Freddy's, including the likes of KSI, Comedy George Gamer. They'll jump out their seats.
You guys stay put. Okay.
Ah! Oh my God, the fucking again! Are you fucking serious? Fuck off! Just fuck off!
The funniest one, is it Blasphemous HD? He jumped way out of his seat.
I'm done.
Awesome cosplay. That is absolutely amazing. Good music here, Linkin Park. I'm waiting for when they do a biopic of Chester Bennington. Fun fact, Linkin Park sold more albums than Queen. Yeah. That, and also, fun fact, Linkin Park, their first three albums outsold any other artist's first three albums in history. Yeah. Yep. I'm a music wizard, by the way. I know a lot about popular music, rock, dance, so much. Yeah. And by the way, I really want Ashley Roberts to win Strictly, but it's unlikely because she's unpopular with the public. Yeah, but I'd love Faye to win as well, and Stacey. Joe Sugg is good as well. I think Lauren is gone tonight. You watch Strictly? Yeah, obviously the best show on Saturday nights. And tonight, I'm a Celebrity Final. Gutted Fleur went out last night. I loved her. She was so fun. I think Harry Redknapp's going to win. He's been really funny. Jason Voorhees wearing a Christmas hat. When's the next Friday the 13th? No, please, I've done nothing wrong. I love your movies. No, no. Quite the busy packed day here, Truro College for Comic Con. Yes, a lot of goods and merchandise to buy as late Christmas presents. Well, not exactly late because, well, how many days left until Christmas from here? 16 days, still a good 2 weeks left. It's played Beat Saber on the VR down there and absolutely love it. It's as fun as the first time. Such brilliant fun and great music, and it's, you know, fun to follow the arrows, the two lightsabers. And I believe that Player Ready Cornwall has their own YouTube channel, and they have, I think, is it a live stream? I'm not sure, but they film and record all the footage and the gameplay of everyone who plays, you know, the VR and Beat Saber here at Cornwall, you know, Comic Con and Geek Fest, uploads to YouTube, and you could see me on their channel if they have all the footage they've recorded today. It's a, you know, fantastic game, Beat Saber, virtual reality quality. Felt like Parzival in Ready Player One. Recently, there's a challenge a lot of people have taken up, mainly on the internet in this country, in Britain. It's called Whamageddon. Is that you must avoid hearing Last Christmas by Wham from December 1st until Christmas Day, and apparently that includes when people are singing it without the song being played around. So I'm going to sing Last Christmas here until everyone, and I'm going to sing Last Christmas and see if anyone loses the Whamageddon challenge. Yeah, it'll be fun, but I just think it's a little disrespectful to George Michael. You have to carry on his legacy the way it is. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next thing, you gave it away. But this year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Don't think no one's here is playing the Whamageddon game, so no one says, oh, thanks, I've lost it, but... Is it true you're back in the Star Wars franchise, you in the Solo film?
I know nothing, you know nothing.
Okay, it's a good way to avoid a spoiler alert, I guess. Next year will be 20 years since The Phantom Menace was released. Do you feel old?
I do now, yeah.
Yeah, what was also released 20 years ago? Next year's 2019, 20 years from 1999. The Matrix is turning 20, so is American Pie. We'll just say to your mother, we ate it all. Also, American Beauty turning 20, Office Space, Toy Story 2, 10 Things I Hate About You, The Green Mile, The Straits.
Can you stop making me feel old now?
What also happened almost 20 years ago? Jill Dando was shot dead at her home. What else happened? Krista Berg won Stars in Her Eyes and the Champion of Champions.
You have a good memory of 1999.
I'm a big pop culture geek. I know a lot about the 90s.
The Millennium Bug was almost also a concern.
Yeah. How many end of the worlds have we survived? There was a Millennium Bug, 2012. Whatever was going to happen in May 2011, no. Just...
But the thing you definitely have forgotten is the problem with Back to the Future is now all in the past.
Yeah.
The entire film is now in the past.
True. 2015 is 3 years ago. And also next year, 2019. That's the year films like Blade Runner and The Island were set in. What?
He can tell you all the names. I just hit people with it to kill them. You know, that's the different ends of the spectrum that can sort of like this. And for me, like for him, he's going to be completely in character an entire weekend, and you know, in his character there's this in his character, but for me I go charge into battle, and then you know, after battle we sit down around a campfire, you know, have a few drinks, make some food. It's just so much fun, and the people are all so nice as well, so yeah, it's just a really nice thing.
And there's something for everyone. So V and I both basically got into it initially the fighting side of it. So I came to it from reenactment. V came to it not from reenactment.
I was dragged along.
I started out, the character I now play started out as a recurring non-player character, because I used to crew as well, and ended up with so much backstory to this character, I ended up just playing him. But if you're not into fighting, then you can do the talking parts, you can be weird users, you can be friendly villager with a problem sent up to continue plot, or if you don't care about plot, if you don't want to have to remember a character brief and actually remember staying in character, you can just do fighting all weekend.
That happens to me all the freaking time. We charge into battle and I go, what's going on? No idea, let's just go kill people.
So it really is something for everything. I love it because it's part of a story which has now been running continuously for over 25 years. So I know that my character's got a realistic chance of leaving his own mark in a story where characters from 10 years ago have passed into legend. When we tell stories around campfires, we mix in Irish mythology because that's all part of the setting, but we're also telling stories about these great characters that have been and gone, and some of them are friends with people still sitting around the campfires and so on.
And then you have, again, people like me who can genuinely listen to these stories because they have no idea what I've been on about.
Any questions? But the back first.
Where are you based?
What
was your question?
Where are you based?
We're based just outside Oakhampton in Devon, a little village called Exbourne. We've got a huge field where the farmer has basically let us build a fort. And then we've got a massive field down below where we can fight all our battles. We've got friendly neighbour farmers as well, so we can go and...
Watch the sheep
here when
you die.
I wasn't going to talk about the sheep.
It's true, though.
If sheep get you going to be, we'll let you go on about the sheep. I was talking about the woods across the river, so that we can go across the river and we can do longer adventures if we need to, so the setting will change. So it's just outside.
Shield, you're dying with a shield.
We have people from over from the Netherlands. In fact, there's a spin-off game which is in the Netherlands which we went both over to in November. But we have a lot of players from Cornwall up to Bristol, Taunton and so on.
Yeah. You can always get a lift. We've got a Facebook group. There's quite often people coming down and car sharing and stuff like that. So cool. It's no issue.
Right. So your question.
I've done reenactment before, so I was wondering, because I ended up in hospital with them one of the times, does it hurt as much?
No.
Okay.
Not as much. We're not going to lie, I don't lie, so it would people sometimes do.
I have a scar under my left eye where I nearly lost my eye to a reenactment spear a few years back. That was steel. This. It's foam filled latex, but you don't want to hit too hard, but it's nowhere near as painful. I'm going to regret that.
Donatello, Michelangelo.
What? No, not Mikey.
Michelangelo, you are.
You don't know?
I'm trying to remember the name, Des. Donatello, Michelangelo.
Come on.
The other two, I'm thinking. Where's the other one?
Come on.
Raphael. Yay! This is where the cafe is, where cosplayers and attendees come out here to chill, have lunch. Mm-hmm. Deadpool returns! Awesome, it's been a fantastic year for you, hasn't it? 2018, been a brilliant year. Mm-hmm. I feel something is missing here at Truro Comic Con Winterfest. Someone is missing. Someone who I really like and look forward to at every convention, and she wasn't here today, as she's probably still busy building her next cosplay, which she couldn't finish in time for until today for Truro Comic Con Winterfest, and that is, of course, Pocky Tesney, who is Nike. Of course, Pocky was Tesney, her real name, Tesney. She was Nike at Geekfest and Truro Comic Con summer this year, and Nemesis from last year. Unfortunately, she had to put Nemesis to sleep and we'll never see her again. Oh God, gonna cry for her. You'll never see me again. But I know Tesney is busy, but I do miss her. Tesney, I miss you.
And I miss you like yeah.
It's 12 o'clock, it's Jack Walker, and now with the main afternoon headlines. Down, down. Yeah, it's pretty comfortable here. Game of Thrones is, of course, ending next year. Well, the last season starts in 4 months, and I mentioned in my last Truro Comic Con vlogs, I don't watch it, but I may watch the last episode just for the hell of it, but not many shows I watch now. I was disappointed with the second season of Westworld, and of course Bates Motel ended over a year ago, but I did enjoy Who is America, Sacha Baron Cohen. That was outrageous and hysterical. Hope there's a second season, but yeah. Now that 2018 is drawing to a close, there's an epic year of sport. What's going to happen in 2019? Women's World Cup, the draw was yesterday. England are with Argentina, Scotland and Japan. Ooh, it should be a juicy group. This is a... yeah. what will happen next year? The Women's World Cup, Rugby World Cup, Cricket World Cup, what else is happening next year? World Athletics Championships, and of course, the inaugural UEFA Nations League final. England in the Final Four playing Netherlands in the semi-finals. It's coming home. If there was an award for best meme of 2018, meme of the year, back in July, it's coming home. All the it's coming home memes. I even jumped on the bandwagon at Geekfest when I did it. Went up to any cosplayer shouting it's coming home. Oh, let's see. I'm already feeling nostalgic about it.
And got onto season 1, episode 1 of Doctor Who from that. And after doing Blink, then I changed my career to be a hair and makeup artist, so that's what I do full time now.
I hate this question because I never know how to answer it, really. I just kind of fell into it. I've done so many jobs over my life, you know, so many different weird jobs. And this is the weirdest of all of them, I guess. I just got a phone call saying, would you like to be on Doctor Who? And I went, yeah. Turns out I didn't even know what I'd be doing. And when I arrived, the assistant director said, you know you're going to be a Dalek, don't you? And I went, oh. So, yeah, first day, Dalek, so brilliant. Never look back.
I said this a few times at the table. My brother did background work, and he got a featured role in Casino Royale, James Bond movie. Woo! He played Mr. Future, and that was a contractor as an actor. And he just really encouraged me to, because he's got a very similar look to me, and he encouraged me to join a few agencies. And I soon got my first job on 47 Ronin with Keanu Reeves. And then just got a few more jobs, really cool jobs. Got a great featured role on a Heineken commercial. And then joined more agencies and got more jobs. And then, I mean, it's got to a point now where I think whenever I go into production, one of the ADs will know who I am anyway. And then it was, that's why I got the job. Any more questions?
Yeah.
What was your career highlight?
Good question. I have to think about that. I don't have one. I don't have a career high. I've not reached a high. I don't think I've reached a high, but I can tell you what ones I've enjoyed. I love working on Doctor Strange. Mm-hmm. I love working in Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm a Marvel fan, so
yeah.
When I was
Same
in Guardians of the Galaxy, and you read all the rumours about who's going to be in it and all that stuff, and there was a rumour that Ronan the Accuser was going to be there in the movie, and I'd only seen him in comic book forms, but then when we were on the kiln prison scene, we saw him walking along, like, oh my god, it's Ronan the Accuser, and I just geeked out. That was my moment of geeking, so that's a big high.
Uh-huh.
I've got two, I think. One was Man from U.N.C.L.E. I was in a helicopter with Hugh Grant, and I had to fall off with him. So that was bizarre. And the other one is Star Wars The Last Jedi, in a tiny little scene on a spaceship with Carrie Fisher and a few others. And she was singing to herself. She gave me a little wink. So I winked back. Yeah, that was brilliant. You can't top that. I can't top that.
I think for me it was doing season 1 episode 1 of Doctor Who with Christoph Eccleston. It was my first TV role, but
Billy Piper.
With Christoph Eccleston, Billy Piper, who I followed since I was a teenager anyway. Christoph Eccleston I just watched sort of Gone in 60 Seconds not that long before it. I was like, oh my god, I'm on TV with a movie star. Like, I'm not only on TV, I'm on season 1 episode 1 of Doctor Who with a movie star. So for me it was that. Anymore. Glenn, you had another question, did you? Hang on a sec.
What are you all working on at the moment?
Well, with the TV industry, it sort of goes a bit quiet over the winter. So, not that long ago, I had a few weeks on The Crown. I was working up in Carnarvon Castle doing the Prince Charles inauguration. But I'm quiet now. I've got a couple of days coming on His Dark Materials, which is the Philip Pullman book. So I've got a few days coming up on that. But otherwise, it's pretty quiet over winter because it's short shooting hours, so we don't do much. Time off.
Well, I'd just gone to bed last night, and I missed an email, which I didn't find till this morning, for the Fast and the Furious spin-off film.
Woo!
And they wanted me to do stunt work on it, and... But it's too late. I didn't find it till this morning, and it was too late. They wanted me to do it today, but I'm here in Cornwall, not in London, so... Well, yeah, that would have been fun, but apart from that, I've just done 3 months on Britannia as a Roman doing sword fighting, being killed, doing all sorts of horrible things. It's great fun.
Next year, I don't know if any of you have met Zara Pippin, who was in Doctor Strange, and she's doing the film next year, and I have a role in that. I haven't seen the script yet, so I can't actually say much about it, but that'll be starting in February. But also, a couple of weeks ago, I just come back from Morocco. I did a film there with Johnny Depp and Mark Rylance and Robert Pattinson. And it was quite an intimate, well, I was going to say intimate scene. That sounded all wrong then, didn't it? But it was... Yeah, how about that? How about that for a career high? Intimate scene with Johnny Depp. Yeah, no, and so that was great. I mean, we had a... Great fun in Marrakesh. And did we do much filming? Yeah, we did a couple of days filming as well. So, and that was quite a great scene though. So hopefully that film's called Waiting for the Barbarian. So hopefully that'll be out next year. I don't know, but yeah, that's what I've been doing.
Can you do the floss?
Oh no!
Oh my God!
Not very good at it. Can we see someone else do it first?
2018 in a nutshell. Oh my god, she can nail it. Lie to me, baby, come.